Welcome back to Dice and Sphere program. All right. So in between videos, I cobbled together just enough, and we are kind of desperate, but I cobbled together just enough resources to make a couple of particle colliders. We spent way too much time dealing with the dark fog. We've got them set up to basically be handled automatically, so we're gonna let that be so. Particle colliders. Cool building, by the way. We want to make strange matter. Particle container. It's funny, this is probably going to be our biggest problem. We've got plenty of deuterium. Not even close to worry about deuterium. Want to see if we can get warpers done this episode. Maybe go out to a new planet. Maybe go so far as to set up a sulfur run. And now I think I need to just import. Though we're so far away, it might not be ideal. Well, some of them found some iron ingots to pull back. I bet you if I went over to my battle weary area over here, we could probably find some iron ingots that are ready to go. More than a few, in fact. I overdid it on the shield generators, but now we have the power and the shield that we otherwise would not have had. I mean, the shield's looking pretty good. We got a couple areas that we need to fill in, but now that we're at full power, it's gonna be much easier. The buildings in this game make amazing sounds. Such a cool building. Okay. One strange matter, 4 diamonds to make a gravitational lens. We need to leave room for the power pole. Let the Tesla tower do its work. And then we'll go like that. Pretty sure there's a huge chunk of diamonds up here somewhere. Or not. Wow, we need coal. We'll have to presume that some of them made their way down here. I mean, we'd be totally wrong, but it's launching for one diamond. I mean, we're right here. So using some of these gravitational lenses here would actually be very tempting. But we're going to stay on task for once. And we're just going to put these in place. One green cube makes 8 warpers, but we're just doing it with the lenses, so we're getting a straight 1-for-1. Warpers, if the distance exceeds the warp distance, vessels must not carry space warpers. Okay, so the warp distance is 60 AU, but I think that's basically, I mean, this is 2.8 AU. And our target is 3 light years. So I think we said 10 AU, that should be enough. And then we're gonna slap 10 of these guys in here. And we're gonna make this our local supply, remote supply of warpers. It's gonna be Care Package Town. Somewhere in this game, there has got to be a ton of... Wait a minute. Are diamonds one of those things you can't make in the replicator? I'm not saying this is a long-term play, but I am saying this is a way to get some diamonds a little quicker. Oh wait, there's actual diamonds just ready to go right here. So that'll make 800 diamonds. That's a little something. We'll continue with this for now, though I'm tempted to just take all of these for ourselves. And then we're gonna load this up with the kind of basics that we always need. Maybe not that basic. So 2,000 rockets in local storage for the purposes of funding all of our scientific exploration. Thank you. Gotta have this guy turn to provide to other locations. Got 28,000 foundations lying around, and that's just kind of slowly, passively making them on two or three machines. But it's always a pain when you get out to another location and find out you don't have any foundations. I'm having a thought here, and it's basically, I'm trying to decide if yeah, that's actually enough. Let's make room. We'll make some accumulators. That's kind of just planning to have some power issues when we get there, because if we look at this planet, which is infested with Hive, by the way, it is also 174% solar energy ratioed. So solar power is the way to go. We actually have 7 warpers. Alright, that's a pretty good care package. Warpers and missiles. Oh, and foundations. What else? I know I want to pull back sulfuric acid just taking a peek as to where it would actually land. I think if this is our sulfuric acid line, having it land somewhere right in here would be perfect. We'll set this to 'remote demand'. We could theoretically set up a battery exchange, but I don't think we're gonna do that. Let's see, what else does this target planet have in store for us besides that Tana Hive? Titanium ore, so all the basics. No coal, unfortunately. We'll make this a clean demand only transportation network. Okay, so the sulfuric acid will come in here, and then eventually we'll probably end up asking for, you know, iron ore at the very least, since we know we're running low on that. get out of the gravitational pull of our planet here. And kind of point the way. We're short on energy, so this is going to be a partial warp. Made a huge mistake. Let me hold off. I'll be right back. I'm gonna let the battery charge up a bit. I should have come out here with a stronger power source and more energy in my tank. Give me a second. All right, let's see if we have enough power to make this trip now. Well, we made it to the system at least. I mean, this game's base shots are just undeniable. Oh, wow. The sulfuric acid is kind of limited. I could grab it from here in a halfway decent way. Is my home being destroyed? There's one unit that survived, and he's probably gonna wreck the whole base. Put down our solar panels. Nice chunk of batteries. Colliding with other objects. Where are my... There they are. Oh, they finally got it. Thank goodness. We could probably go with, say, 3,000 total. So these 10 turrets will protect the other 10 turrets. And that will overcome their short distance limitation. Feels like we've been in the dark for a while here. Well, we got the rockets. Let's put in a little request for full accumulators. And we'll put in the basic request for the opposite. And we'll only ask for, I don't know, 2,000 at the max, which we should never hit. Of course, that process won't start until we find some sunshine. think we'll put another defense down. Oh, we already have one down. It's just that it's not powered. Alright, and let's put in defense for this side. What? We're getting wrecked already? Oh, I didn't set this output to be rockets. Suddenly, we're defending ourselves. They're colliding with each other. A little inline. Oh boy. It's getting shot directly there for a second. We'll bring back the tower for that section. We just need to get these guys cleared out. They're too close for comfort. Why are we shooting so weird? Alright, so this outpost for the missiles has its own taunt tower. This one doesn't. So that makes that vulnerable. And our power solution has its own taunt tower. So yeah, we need one for over here. I didn't bring enough signal towers with me. Remote supply. This far out, spending warpers, I feel obligated to have the vessels be fully loaded. There it goes. They get out of the gravitational well and then they just hit the warper. We need to get some more warpers in here so we can kick this into high gear. I think we're going to try to run this one strictly on solar power. The key is going to be to have enough solar panels to fully charge all of our accumulators. And to have enough accumulators to last us through the night. Let's take back at least one iron ore. We are not getting enough warpers. Of course, we're not making enough warpers. And I think all of that is because we are... Actually, that wasn't a full sentence, sorry. The point of us coming out here to get this sulfur is because we don't have enough warpers. So it is a bit of a catch-22. We are in a situation where we want more warpers, but in order to get more warpers, we have to use buildings. Those buildings require titanium alloys, and those alloys require sulfur. So it might be a bit tough to get warpers out here right now. I did see that I had a few in my inventory, though. Let's set these aside. And then... What are you gonna do with it if I give you some warpers? What are you gonna do? Take out some iron ore? take out some sulfur. All right, well, that's what I want, so... I think I'm gonna move you to this side just so we cover more of our missile battery. I mean, there's no reason to keep these empty accumulators in my inventory. We're gonna need one good hit of warpers out here to really make this thing go. Somewhere we have a break in our defenses, but I'll probably take care of that in between videos. Thank you. 3 seconds till arrival. Wait, why are we stuck at 6 seconds till arrival? Another one of these classic respawn. Man, they are taking some direct shots. Of course, now I'm taking my direct shots. Perfect. Of course, now we don't have the energy to land, but we're getting there quicker. Oh man, this is going to be a trip. Hold on, I'll be right back once we land. All right, let's see what happened here. Looks like they just decided to go a different way. HR6701L should be able to handle itself. I wouldn't mind a bit of a charge in the power area. Let's head to the home factory. Let's see if anything is actually happening. Ideally, we would at least see some sulfuric acid, or we can make some tweaks. Huh. I knew that was gonna happen. If I didn't veer off, we would have landed right in the middle of a hive. There we go. Actually, perfect landing. We have 10 warpers for use by this group. 29 warpers for use by this group. Remote demand, current, 2,000 out of 10,000. Oh, it's the same problem every single time. I need to set this output to sulfuric acid. That conveyor belt's gonna run. Thank you. Looks like we have done it, at least to some extent. At the very least, our sulfuric acid supply has dramatically increased. There we go. We needed to put some logistics vessels on here. Now we're doing it. Plus 2,500 sulfuric acid and plus 3,000 iron ore. I am looking for stone. Apparently, that's another thing that we're short on. Oops. Just gonna add more iron ingots to this system here. We'll just put it all in here so that way we can deal with it in a single stream. Just a nice little iron ingot supply. Just to provide a little bit of kind of take the strain off of our current production. Actually, I don't need a separate line here, do I? Yeah. Uh-oh. Power issues. Actually, I think I might have a couple of full accumulators on me. Or not. We're generating a ton. I think we upgraded our logistics vessels. I wonder if that 10% kind of put us over whatever limit to actually get this stuff to move. Well, these are processing at the very least. It's just gonna take a while. Okay, yeah. We went way longer than we should have. That's okay. We got the sulfuric acid supply. We've added some additional iron ore. We've put that into place. I think we're working through it. We'll have to see. We might have to put a couple more lines of this in place here. And actually, for whatever reason, that's way too close. Yeah, the paint line is right here. We'll cut that out just as a reminder. I guess as long as this continues to pile up, we could export from here as well. It's kind of long distance, so it'll only be occasionally. Oh, yeah, and we're also doing it directly from the tower itself, so that's also good. Lots of opportunities. All right, let's see what happens. This drops in, drops off 1500. Looks like primarily this line gets full and then a couple of drones come in and pick up some of the rest. Yeah, that's perfect. Yeah, that's great. And then I might steal the warpers from here and put them over here so we can start getting that sulfuric acid. I'm gonna put in a little kind of a side storage here, but we'll only ask for 4 total. And it looks like we're currently short titanium. Yeah, it looks like we really satisfied the sulfuric acid requirement. Let's take another peek. 12 million titanium ore. It might make sense to grab that in the next episode. Thanks for hanging out. I do appreciate it. And we'll see you next time.